Hello traders, this is James Stanley with StoneX and FOREX.com. Wanted to take a look at pound dollar as it's putting in a test of a pretty big support level, one that I talked about in yesterday's webinar, and wanted to do an update on that pair. First, we need to look at a risk disclaimer. I'm gonna leave this up for 15 seconds up front. I'll also have it 30 seconds in the back end, and it will be in the description field of this video. Please read that. I'll meet you on the other side and we'll start looking at pound dollar. Right, that is 15 seconds on my watch. And there is pound dollar. In yesterday's webinar, I shared that I thought this was one of the more attractive backdrops for USD weakness scenarios. And I was specifically looking at the 130 psychological level, which is a pretty major spot in cable and has been for a while. We saw this come in as resistance in July. There was a very short-term test above that. But at the time, we had RSI overbought. That led to a pullback. That pullback found support at this trend line that can be found from the October 22 swing low connected to the April 22 swing low. And so far, we've seen a bit of reaction off of that 130 level. As you can see here, as I go a little short term, there we go. And technically, the low is like 2 pips above the big figure, which when I see that, I kind of read it that there was enough anticipation from bulls to come in ahead of a test of the big figure and something that could be of interest for forward-looking price action. But first, I wanted to take a look at the dollar because whenever I'm looking at a major pair, that's something I want to take into consideration. And this was something I was talking about a couple of weeks ago as we had that first oversold reading in DXY since January of 2018. It's quite a long time ago. And I'd went on about this in the webinar a bit, so if you wanna hear more, feel free to check that out. But last week was, I think, a pretty important deal. We saw DXY get slammed on Friday, but notice where it held a slightly higher low right at that 100 spot 62 level above the prior swing low from late August. And that led into a pretty visible bounce. But with that said, even with those supports playing out or holding over the last few weeks, bulls have not been able to fire a really strong topside run. And so if we do see the range continuing in short-term USD price action, that's what I think keeps short-side USD as attractive in a couple of different pockets of the market. Of course, in Eurodollar, it looks like we might soon have a 110 test. But I'm looking at cable. And given the recent strength is a little bit greater than euro, is perhaps even maybe a little more attractive for those types of scenarios. But getting back to pound dollar, a hold of that 130 level would be key and would be important. But if we go down shorter term, I'm going to go down to like a 2 hour chart. You'll notice that we've essentially had a continuation of lower lows and lower highs. So bulls have some work to do if they want to retake control. And there's this swing low right around 130.50. And there's some historical reference there. And there's that swing low at like 130.58. So a rather tight little zone. But if this bounces and finds resistance there, then sellers still have an open door to push down for either another test of that 130 level or perhaps even below that. But what I'd want to see if that lower high resistance does play is bulls come in to hold a higher low, thereby defending the 130 spot. And kind of like I said a moment ago, if I go down to a 1 minute chart, you'll notice that swing low comes in right at like 130.02. And when I see that type of thing, I imagine that bulls were watching the tape. They saw it get close to 130. They didn't want to wait. They didn't want to miss out. And FOMO gets the best of them, so they jump in ahead of time. So that becomes the focal point. I want to see some element of defense there to keep the door open for topside setups, topside scenarios. And if we do see that range in USD holding, I think this is something that could retain some attraction for a couple of days into next week. But that, my friends, is what I have for today on pound dollar. Thank you so much for watching. This is James Stanley signing off. Thank you, folks.